What's up, sir? Yes, good to sir. See you, champ.
Lennox, thank you so much for being with us. What should fans expect from a great Saturday night of fighting here in Brooklyn at the Barclays Center?
Yeah, a lot of drama. Boxing always brings the drama. You never know what to expect. You know, like, I went to the fight the other day with the big heavyweights, Deontay and Tyson Fury. Mm-hmm. I would never expect what happened.
Man.
Yeah, it was unbelievable. That's this is what fight fans want to see. They want to see excitement. They want to see something they never expected to see.
The storylines, yeah, all of it.
All that.
So. I was reading some stuff, and you were doing a review of that heavyweight fight, and you said, if these guys, they fight again, both of them should have learned a great deal from that fight. Will you express to the fans what they should have learned? Because both of them, you had great examples of things during the fight that, man, long term, it helps them to be better boxers and to be able to face each other again.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you know, Deontay, he learned that, you know, you got to learn to box. You got to learn that jab is very effective. He learned that not everybody you can knock out, you know, eventually, there's a guy that's going to be in there, is going to be the same speed as you, same skills as you, mm-hmm. and you can't knock him out. So you're going to have to do something different. So what he's learned is you got to box. So he's you know, next fight, he's going to probably be boxing. And what Tyson Fury learned, he learned, like, no, don't bend down. Being a 6'9" guy, don't bend down.
Make yourself shorter.
Shorter and allow a guy to come down on you with all that leverage and knock you out. So each one of these fighters always learns something. So.
And that was, and I want to talk about this event here in a second, but that was, everyone in the arena, including most notably Deontay Wilder, thought the fight was over. Fight was over. And then Tyson Fury did, I mean, to cross sports, the Undertaker all of a sudden. He just sat up from the dead. And it was, I thought a draw was great in that because now we're guaranteed to see it again, even if you thought Fury won the fight. But let's talk about this. Jermall Charlo, I know the Charlo twins. I used to briefly go to the same gym where they train at in Houston.
An amazing
story of these two guys, twin brothers. Thankfully, as we were talking about, different weight classes, so they don't have to worry about fighting each other. But both now champions. Jermall's in an odd spot because a late switch. Now he's going to fight Korobov, who I know is not who he was training for. Tell us about that fight, and then in general, when you all of a sudden have a different guy that you're going to be fighting against for a belt, what that's like.
Well, anytime you change your opponent, you change your mindset. This guy is going to come at you with something different that you didn't prepare for. And it's always difficult fighting those type of guys because, you know, they come out with something that you've never expected or you haven't had time to work on. Mm-hmm. So it's going to be an interesting fight. We're going to have to see how well they adapt. One's more aggressive. One leans back and does more boxing. So it'll be an interesting fight. A lot of drama in that fight, too.
What about with the other brother, with Jermell and Tony Harrison? What should fans look for in that one?
Well, that would be a little bit tougher fight because Tony comes and he's aggressive and he comes at you. So we're going to have to see how he deals with that.
All right, so let's talk heavyweights for a second. The opener, you have Dominic Breazeale against Carlos Negron. If either of these guys win, do you think they get a title shot?
Maybe have another couple fights to kind of warm them up for that. It depends on how they look.
Lennox, in the break, we were talking a little bit more about how you could take where we're fighting, where boxing is right now, and bring it back to where it was, you know, a little bit years ago, where more people can see it, more people were following what you talked about, the drama and the storylines. You had some ideas of where you think fans could see it or how they could take boxing back into the popular time that it was.
You know, it should be easy for people to turn on the TV and watch boxing. You know, anybody that loves fighting sports, they should be able to turn on the TV and see boxing and learn about guys that they've never learned about before. What usually happens, a guy gets famous, nobody really knows about him, then all of a sudden he's on Fox, he's on all these different pay-per-view channels, nobody knows him, so they don't really want to buy into him. What they need to do is grow up with him. Grow up seeing him on the TV.
That's the way it used to be.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm a huge fan of boxing. I've been to a lot of your fights and everything. And the thing about even yourself, there were great fighters then, but we knew about you coming up in the ranks. Yeah. And in your day, I mean, you're a great athlete. How do we attract some more of the great athletes? Muhammad Ali and some of the other guys, Sugar Ray, Thomas Hunter, great athletes boxing. How do we attract those great athletes back to the sport that you love?
I think it starts with the amateurs. Amateurs, you know, you need that amateur build-up. You need these guys to come into the amateur sports and, you know, learn how to box correctly, learn the biomechanics of the sport. And, you know, this is where they learn from before they turn pro. A lot of them, like, have 10 fights and then they turn pro. I've had an extensive amateur career, 2 Olympics and, you know, over 200 fights as an amateur. Now I'm ready to turn pro. When I turn pro, I'm already gone through 10 fights. You know, these guys are going through 30 fights as professionals. I went through 100 fights as an amateur. So right now I find that the boxers are learning as they get to the top.
And so one of the things you were talking about as far as it being accessible to the general public, that's one of the cool things about these events now being on Fox. Everybody, mm-hmm. People that don't have this channel have regular Fox. They have what we call Big Fox. It's going to be on Saturday nights, which is what you're talking about. Guys being able to, without having to necessarily pay a cost for it, turn on a fight, watch it, drink a beer with their buddies, and start to learn who these guys are. I think the Charlo twins are stars. I think people will like the fact that they're brothers, unlike the Klitschko brothers, who are in the same weight class, would never fight each other, and that put a stall on the heavyweight division for a decade. These two guys, you could have two twin brothers who for the next few years are the dominant faces of their weight class as we kind of age out of the Mayweather-Pacquiao era. Yeah. For as I know, you're obviously so the heavyweight champ of the world, and for a long time that's the baddest man on the planet.
That's right.
It's really been since your era ended, the most prominent boxers have been these guys' sizes. For people that are now coming back to boxing after your era, tell us a little bit about difference stylistically from the way these guys fight to the way you would fight in your famous matches.
You're talking the heavyweights or just the
like the difference between a middleweight fighter who we're going to see this weekend versus the way you fought.
Well, me, I was, it could all end in one punch. I don't get really paid for overtime, so I'm trying to take you out as soon as possible. You know, I find the smaller weight classes, obviously they don't get paid for overtime either. But they're more boxing, they're more flashy, and there's more of a game plan. I had a game plan as well, and if my game plan failed, I forgot another one. There's, you know, A, B, and C game plan. Sometimes with these guys, they only have one game plan.
Right. Now, what would you do to be able to bring back some of the kind of luster that has been lost with boxing to the heavyweight? If you could make an adjustment, what would you do to boxing now, especially as far as the heavyweights? Because people will always be attracted to that division. And as you mentioned, man, the fastest man in the world and the baddest man in the world. Heavyweight champ and whoever wins the 100 meters. What would you do to be able to bring some of that back?
Make there only be one belt. One belt. You know, when you get all these belts hanging around, champion over here, champion over here, champion over here, and then, you know, everybody wants to see these guys fight, but yet they don't fight. Now it's getting to a point where, you know, people are getting sick of it. They want to see the good fighters box the good fighters. And, you know, that's what Fox is doing, so I'm happy.
Wait, Lennox, before we leave you, I do have to ask. CC says that, and as a professional athlete, there's no athlete in better shape than a boxer at the top of his game. The way he trains, the way he practices, how prepared he is. At your most competitive, just how many hours a day were you training? Just give me an idea. I have to know what he's talking about.
It was like 8 hours a day, you know.
8 hours?
Yeah.
How many miles you running? How many sit-ups you doing?
I never ran miles. I ran in time, so it would be like an hour and a half running, you know.
That's insane.
Well, yeah. I mean, well, you got to think if you're playing 12-round fight.
Yeah.
Anyone that hasn't ever sparred or boxed or anything, just try to just run in place for 3 minutes. Just run in place for 3 minutes. Take a one. Nobody punching you. Right. You're not punching anybody. Just run in place for three.
No, forget that. Try shadow boxing. Throwing punches just for a minute.
Just for a minute, and
with power too. Yeah. Add the power to it.
All right, I thought you were gonna go somewhere else before before we go, Jenna. When you do the toss, Jenna is actually British.
Oh,
and so she puts on an American accent. If you wouldn't mind, could you, as when we leave, can you grade her the way Jenna Wolf actually talks?
Let me hear.
The sexy British lady out.
Yes, let a true
come
British
on,
girl.
Come on, I'm a better trainer than I am. Lennox, thank you so much for joining us today. We'll be watching Saturday night on Fox. More First Thing First right after this.
All right. All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, brother. Thank you, appreciate it. Right. Welcome to Fox, man.
Thank you.
I really thought that's what you were going to do. Lennox, I have to ask you. Great my British accent.
Take your razor, yep. Up and down, never side to side, Shakim. You got it?